Just based on the history of what's happened on this planet, it's nothing personal, okay? And the white people who know the truth know that, and they have no issue with it, right? You got an issue with it? Check out Admitted Racist Jane Elliott and Admitted Racist Tim Wise. Check them out. Go talk to them. See what they got to say, okay? President Andrew Johnson, he took all the land back. The original plan during the Civil War, right after the end, it shouldn't be called a Civil War because there's nothing civil about war, right? But after that battle or insurrection happened, the plan was to take the land from the slave masters or the slave owners and divide it up amongst the slaves so that each slave, you know, slaves got some land. Well, President Andrew Johnson, he reversed that plan, right? You know, this was something so the slaves could be self-sufficient, right? Of course, because if you got your own land, right, then you can provide your own vegetables, you know, your own fruits and vegetables. You can cultivate the land. You got your house on your land, and you can survive. You got a way, right? But Andrew Johnson came through, took all that land back from them, and gave it back to the slave master. And then on top of that, they gave money to a lot of the slave owners to compensate them for the loss of slaves. All the while, what'd they give the slave? Nothing. So most of the slaves, ex-slaves, so supposedly so-called ex-slaves, ended up doing what? They ended up falling into what they wrote into the 13th Amendment, which said that basically you don't have to be, you won't be a slave unless you commit a crime. They made up all these little crappy ass laws like loitering. Like no loitering, a behavior that the slaves developed from hanging around the store because of the, you know, let's say, you know, me and Thiz's mama. Let's put it this way, because this happened a lot in slavery. And I know I've done the research. The slave master up the road, Massa Smith wants to have some baby. He needs to have some baby. So he want to get his wench pregnant, right? So he comes over to my massa, Massa George, and says, George, I need your nigga to get my niggas impregnated so we can have some babies. I'll sell the babies and you can get profit. We mean you can split the profit. So he gets his niggas all fancied up, his wench, she's wearing some nice clothes and smelling all good. And they bring her over to see me. And I'm like, ooh, Lordy. Ooh, I finally get to get me some. Massa said I could get me some. That's all most of the black males was good for, was working in the field and having sex. Spreading the seed. Most of y'all still got that habit right now. That's all you want to do. You just want to have babies. Right? So, she's pregnant. She on the other plantation. She has Thiz. They sell Thiz to another plantation. But all three plantations shop at the same store. So they send me to the store to go get some groceries for Massa. So I go to the store and I'm waiting at the store because I'm hoping to find a slave who works on the same plantation that his mama works on. Or maybe I might even see her and they could tell me what plantation Thiz is on. That's where the loitering came about. You know, if you look around, like if you look in the, when I was telling you about Grand Theft Auto 5 earlier, they got the whole hood down pat. You look, when you driving around in the game on the side of town where the black dude lives at, you'll see all kinds of victims hanging out, standing out in front of the stores, talking loud and everything. You know where we got, where we get all the loud talking from? Because, you know, a lot of y'all know, you know, when we talking loud, they say that's primitive or, you know, discourteous or whatever. We got that because the slave masters never wanted to hear us whispering. If we was whispering or we was talking in a low tone, that meant that we was up to something that they didn't want us to be up to. So to keep us in the mindset of not planning something or doing something they didn't want us to be doing, they trained us to be talking loud. So you go hang out at the store and you wait there at the store for somebody that's from one of the other plantations. You say, yo, man, what's happening on the plantation? What's happening on such and such? What's going on? And that just became a habit that black people developed. And we still do it now. We just don't know why we do it. We just don't know why. But they knew why we was doing it, and they made it illegal. They came up with the crime of loitering. Now, today, loitering is more like a misdemeanor. What is loitering? Loitering says remaining in any one place with no apparent purpose. Hanging out with no apparent purpose. So they end up putting you in greater confinement. The 13th Amendment to the United States Constitution abolished slavery and involuntary servitude except as punishment for a crime. So during that period of time, look, what you got? You ain't got no land. You don't have a house to stay in. You ain't got no job. You don't have no place to grow your own fruits and vegetables. So what happens to you? The other one was vagrancy, which is, you know, a hobo, you know, being so-called homeless. That was another rule. And what happened? You go back, you go into greater confinement. The prisons would put you right back on the same plantation that you just got supposedly free from. The approval came via his successor, President Andrew Jackson, who encouraged the reconstructed southern states of Alabama, North Carolina, and Georgia to agree, which brought the count to 27 states, leading to its adoption before the end. Though 3 million Confederate slaves were in fact freed by Lincoln's Emancipation Proclamation, their post-war status was uncertain. That means after war. Post means after. I don't know why they don't just say after. To ensure the abolition was beyond legal challenge, an amendment to the Constitution to that effect was initiated. On April 8, 1864, the Senate passed an amendment to abolish slavery. After one unsuccessful vote and extensive legislative maneuvering by the Lincoln administration, the House followed suit on January 31st. The measure was swiftly ratified by nearly all northern states, along with a sufficient number of border states, slave states not part of the Confederacy, up to the assassination of President Lincoln. However, the approval came via successor Andrew Johnson. So anyways, you know, these jokers become slaves again, you know. Insane in the membrane.